tell Kirby that you're serious. This is Peach. That's Tammy. This is Sapphire and the rest of the girls. Would you hear from Missouri Delicacy Man? This year, Captain cooked real slow.
Cats!
He was lonely, man. He just eased him out of his misery. I stepped in with some mom, not sure if he's gonna fix it and cut him some berries.
Okay, I take it back.
someone beside yourself. I'll never be as smart as you, Tom. It comes from reading books. Reading?
Go forth and spread the word, remembering all who do not know need to be told.
picture of a ship in Sid's history book? I cannot tell a lie. That was the one that done it. Don't you lie to me! Say, it's you who done it.
Oh, yes, ma'am. Sid could have my history textbook. I'll put the shellac on Miss Dalvin's finds out.
Thank you for telling the truth, but I think I'll leave the punishment up to Miss Dalvin. All right, everyone, get ready for bed.
better things to do. You felt the back of my hand a little more often and learned some respect.
What are you doing out here?
Well, what do you think? I come to get my boy, that's what.
What do you need with me?
A man's own flesh and blood, asking a question like that. Well, a father and his son were to be together.
Ain't that right, Miles?
What do you want with me? Mouse is your partner, ain't he?
Ha! Onlyest thing Mouse is good for is standing there scaring people. Oh, sure, he looks ugly enough and all, but all he's got for brains is mush. Ain't that right, Mouse?
How did your partner out with him?
Oh, he escaped from the institution a couple of months ago. I found him wandering out in the woods, taught him how to beg. Hey, Mouse, show up here how you can beg.
Got a penny for a poor man. Got a penny. Oh, please, sir, won't you give me a penny? I ain't up for 3 days.
Tell him no, you ain't got a penny, and see what happens.
No, I ain't got a penny.
You sure you ain't got a penny?
If I were you, I'd give him a penny. Once he's asked, he don't like to be disappointed.
No. I got this 10 cent though.
Oh, good enough.
Hey, you know why they call him Mouse?
No, why?
Because he eats them.
Ain't that right, Mouse?
Back at the institution, they didn't need no cats. All they needed was him. Why, he'd sit outside that mouse hole all day if he had to. When that critter popped his head out, there was Mouse. Whomp, he goes with his hand, just scoops that critter up and eats him as is. Ain't that right, Mouse?
What kind of institution was this?
What kind of people was in that place, you say?
Loonies.
Yeah, that's right. It was for loonies.
So what line work are you in now?
Oh, a little of this, a little of that. Begging for one, a couple other matters I ain't at liberty to discuss.
I don't think I'd be any use to you as a beggar. I ain't begged for over a year now. I'm living in the Widow Duggins.
Huh. Looks to me like you're living in this here swamp.
Well, I was going to go back any day now. You can't just come and take me away.
Don't tell me what I can't do. I'm your father, and I can do with you what I darn well please. Unless...
Unless what?
Unless the Widow Duggins would care to buy you.
What?
I've been checking around, and I happen to know the old gal's got some money stashed away. It wouldn't hurt her at all to share some of it.
How much are we going to ask for?
Oh, I reckon $10,000 is the fair price.
$10,000? She won't do it. It ain't right.
What ain't right is them taking my only child. Now, you're going to go back there and tell her to cough up that cash, or else.
Else what?
Else I'm going to take my boy, and she ain't never going to see him again. Now, me and Mouse, we got some unfinished business down the river at least. We'll be back come Saturday. There ain't $10,000 in cash on this here stump by midnight. And I'm going to come and get you. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Go on! $10,000. You know what that means, Mouse?
No, what?
No more scratching, digging to get by.
Yeah.
What are we going to do with all that money? Oh. I'm going to buy a piece of land and build a little shack with 100 jugs of whiskey in the shed out back. What about you, Mouse? What are you going to do with your share?
Me? I'm going to build a little house with lots of little walls, and I'm gonna paint it pink and fill it up with dolls.
Dolls?
Just a bit, dolls, mister.
Oh, I love dolls. Some of my best friends are dolls. Money, 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 money.
Money, 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 money.
Gotta get my fingers on some money, 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 money.
Gotta fill my pockets full of money, money, money.
Gonna have a great big pile of cash.
Thank you.
God, I get my fingers on some money, 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 money.
Gotta fill my pockets full of money, money, money.
Gonna have a great big pile of, gigantic pile of, humongous pile of cash!
If you want to go back there, you gotta pay attention.
You guys got your memory.
Let ourselves live a little bit, only to let the dirt fill the up. How can you happen here now? I
friend. And if I see you in these parts again, I'm gonna slice you up, yourself. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Very well. We'll spare you this time. Come on.
Sheriff says we're gonna have to confiscate your own
over my dead body.
Jesus.
best actress says it's time to start.
Giselle, you could wear something a little dressier in church.
You haven't heard any kids.
Hightower has kindly consented to being our soloist this morning.
up last Sunday afternoon and scared the children of our Sunday school half to death. Poor children, I'm going home. Wherever they are, they should be pent. The visitor is knocking at their door, and they're about to let him in. Now, what should we say to the visitor when he knocks? Repeat after me. We should say,
Huckleberry has been kidnapped. tonight. Bring a doll. You can crawl out the window. P.S. Don't tell your grandma. Alfred, what is this about?
I don't know, but he said it's awful important.
Tell him already.
He's a marvelous boy. He lacks common sense. He's destined to be a great man. He worries me so. He's courageous, I know. I'll keep him from jail if I can. He's a bird flying high, a cloud in the sky, a ride on the merry-go-round. He's a boy revolt, a frisky young colt. His conscience is never around. Was there ever such a boy as Tom Sawyer? Ever such a boy as this? He's a marvelous boy, a mischievous boy, a boy who lives in my dreams. He's an impish young lad, a handsome young lad, a bag full of capers and schemes. But I love him, and I love him.
Here's the trio they got.
Dolly's name.
Oh, this is Rachel. You want to see her?
I like dolls. This here is Mouse. I named him after me. Mouse, this is Rachel.
Hi, Mouse. Hi, Rachel. How are you? I'm good. But I sure would be better if I knew where Huckleberry was.
I'm not supposed to tell.
Oh, it's okay. You can tell Rachel where Huckleberry is.
Nope. I promise not to tell him until we get the money. What's in the box?
Oh, just some of my pets. Want to see?
Yeah. Mice? I like mice. Do you suppose I could play with them?
I don't know.
Oh, please.
Well, maybe you can tell me where Huckleberry is.
I'm not supposed to.
Oh, well, then I'm just going to be taking my pets and going home now.
Okay, he's at the old mill. But my partner's there with him, and he ain't going to give him back until we get the money.
At the old mill, you said?
Uh-huh, all tied up.
Okay, well, I have to go now, but I'll leave my mice for you.
Okie dokie.
He's at the old mill.
Giselle, we'll lead them down the old mill road. You wait for us at the bottom of the hill.
Anywhere? You seen him anywhere?
Up in their tree. Yeah.
Thank you.
y'all know the rules. There's to be no cussing, no spitting, no catcalls, and no horse playing.
Hey, how you get that? See, that's corporate.
Anyone's curious about the penalty for the aforementioned match by the tribe? See?
Phoebe, why are those two people tied up without their rope?
So they won't escape, Your Honor.
Oh, good idea. Is the jury seated?
Right there, Your Honor.
What a hungry looking bunch. Any of you jury members have reservations about hanging someone if an eye say you've got a revolt that way? Mm-hmm. I'll take that as a no. Now then, we have here the case of Ezekiel Finn, or a bunch of stuff he's done wrong. I am here from all concern, then I'll make a decision. And when I decide to hang someone, we'll do it right after the trial. First witness is Ezekiel Finn. Swear to him.
Stand up. Raise your right hand. Now, do you, Ezekiel Finn, solemnly swear to answer all the questions asked of you without telling so much as one single lie?
Yup.
Is he?
That boy over there named Huckleberry, is he your boy?
Yep, raised him from a pup. Went to all that trouble of raising him, and now witch rock.
Now I am holding in my hand a note that was affixed to the widow Douglas's door with this here knife. Says something about it. Handed over $10,000, and she'll never see him again. Are you the one that affixed said note to said door with said knife?
I ain't never seen that note before in my life.
He's lying. He's the one that done it.
Who said that?
I did. Josephine, you're embarrassing me.
What is your name?
Joe. He's lying. He's the one that did that.
You hold your tongue, young man, or I'll...
Why, Josephine is not a young man, sir. She is a young lady.
What? What'd you say your name was?
Joe.
Well, look at the way you're dressed. Phoebe, look up the penalty for a girl dressing like a boy and slapping on what's her name there.
It ain't against the law.
Don't you sass me. Well, Taylor was something. You just make it up. Now then, where were we? Oh, yeah. Finn, you say, wasn't you kidnapped Huckleberry?
No, sir.
You got your character references?
Yeah, I do.
Well, who are they?
His name's Mouse.
Where's this Mouse?
Here I am.
You know this man?
Yes, sir.
Is he a God-fearing, law-abiding, respectful sort of man, or is he a ornery varmint?
Well, he ain't no vermin now, is he, Mouse? No! See, my dolly says so.
You and your dolly get off the stand. You too, Finn. Esther Douglas, take the stand.
Esther!
Now, are we to understand that Huckleberry has been living with you this past year?
Yes, Your Honor.
And what advantages have you given the boy in that period?
Him again.
Is this Farmer Tom Sawyer in the courtroom?
I'm here, sir.
You you want to step up here and tell me what my granddaughter is doing climbing down the trellis at midnight?
Well, she was only like 11 o'clock when we climbed down the trellis. Was it midnight when we got to the graveyard?
Graveyard! Sheriff, you live there, Roach. You tie a noose in it right now because we're going to take this boy out and hang him.
It ain't customary to hang someone coming through the
city. It ain't customary to make my granddaughter go to the graveyard at midnight.
He's a juvenile. He can't hang you.
Who said that? Tyra. I said Tyra.
Silas and Tyra. I can't sound no woman.
Oh, we'll do it together. Now then, where were we? Oh yeah, we're starting to figure out who kidnapped Huckleberry.
I have an idea, Your Honor.
Oh, you did, Olivia.
Why did you ask Huckleberry?
Ask Huckleberry. Hadn't thought of that. Huckleberry Finn, who was it that kidnapped you? So it was you. How dare you tell me it wasn't you? He's my own boy, Your Honor. Now, how can you kidnap your own boy?
Oh, yeah. Forgot about that part.
Oh, please, Your Honor. If you don't make Huck go back to his father, I swear I'll get rid of the Tyra apples. I'll never scare the Sunday school kids again.
It was him! He's the one! And a black hat and a black thing on his nose is going to kill us all with a sword!
Are you telling me, young man, it was you who pulled that nasty trick?
Didn't do much.
Well, as the leader of this little group, Mr. Sawyer, would you care to say a couple words?